Vartel, ook welkom op VMworld 2011. Naast me zit Jonathan Clark. En ik denk dat we wat interessante vragen voor hem hebben. Hey Jonathan, nice to see you and nice to be here. So interesting questions for you. We know each other from, well, I think 4 or 5 years. Thin stall time frame. Maybe you can explain what your role within VMware is and what you're doing.
Yeah, sure. I'm a principal engineer at VMware, and I'm helping with a number of projects in the enterprise user computing group. And those projects are ThinApp, ThinApp Factory, Horizon, and Atlas. So we can get a little bit into each of those. And I don't know if you want to reminisce on any of the old days, but I think we were recently working together on the Project VRC stuff as well. Which is pretty interesting as well. So we can maybe get into that.
Beneficial is VRC beneficial for VMware as well? What's your take on that?
Yeah, it's great. I think performance, how fast an application starts up, is a really important metric that a lot of our customers look at in terms of having the solution be acceptable for their end users. If it takes too long, people complain and the solution doesn't get deployed. Yeah. So it's good.
So I've seen a session yesterday about ThinApp Factory. I know, ThinStall is a ThinApp is an important portion of that. What is your take on the ThinApp Factory, and what are the use cases? What kind of applications are useful, and what is the functionality of ThinApp Factory?
Yeah, so ThinApp Factory, we showed like a tech preview last year. It was a quick prototype that we had an intern do, and the acceptance was pretty phenomenal, that people really wanted it. So this year we've built it. It's almost a finished product, and we're showing it off as another technical preview, but much more mature. And the goal is to really make it super simple to build a big catalog of applications. And we're targeting two different...
You're talking about Windows applications, right?
Desktop Windows applications. And so with application virtualization, you have various things that you need to do with setting up a clean VM, downloading the app, finding out how to install it, capturing it, and then copying it out, and doing configuration as well. And so ThinApp Factory is a project designed to automate that full process, where it talks to either Workstation or vSphere, and can also talk to ISV websites, so that it knows when there's a new version of an app. You can add new apps to what we call feeds, which are sort of like RSS content that can be dynamic. So you can add and remove feeds.
So you don't download the complete package, because from a legal perspective, you're not allowed to do that.
Exactly. I mean, in an ideal world, we would just give you a virtualized office and be done with it. But we don't own the redistribution rights for Office, so we can't do that. Plus, you might have various configuration changes that are unique to your environment, so our package wouldn't be suitable for you. So what it's doing is it's got sort of a recipe that is in computer format that's fully executable and automated, that knows how to acquire Office either from your internal repositories or from MSDN directly off of Microsoft. Download it. It actually provisions VMs for you, so you don't have to set up and install and maintain XP and Windows 7 images. It can do it in batch operations, so you can have bank loads of VMs that are doing operations for you automatically. But the real goal is to...
So that's a repackaging. That's a repackaging part.
That's the repackaging, or converting into the virtualized format.
Is there analysis available as well to make sure? Well, within app you cannot virtualize every application. So how does the factory knows what kind of applications are able to repackage to a virtual format?
Yeah, I think once we get the basic packaging done, that'll be the next step, is integration points for various things. Like, for example, if you wanted to do antivirus scans on stuff before you've packaged it up, maybe you're downloading stuff from places that you don't trust, or you want to do suitability analysis or testing on different desktop images. Yeah. And this provides a platform for us to integrate with all these different products.
Interesting. That's an interesting one. What I've seen so far is that there's a lot of communication about Horizon Application Manager. I've seen a session about ThinApp and Horizon Application Manager. What is Horizon Application Manager and why is it important for VMware?
Right. Well, in terms of, you know, making the whole process really simple, we've got two sides of the house. We've got the administrator house, and for him, you know, App Factory is trying to address the problem of creating these packages and keeping them maintained. And then if you go to the other side, the end users, how do they actually get the apps, make sure that they're entitled, they're allowed to use them, making that as simple as possible. Horizon is the platform to do that. And by making it a hosted service, we've eliminated the need to have servers deployed in your environment, but also allowed you to start moving things outside the firewall. If you look at
will people complain about or have difficulties that it's a hosted service? What do you think about it?
As a hosted service, there definitely will be some people who will push back on that. And we've taken a lot of design criteria to make sure we reduce that as much as possible. So we don't actually ever export, say, users' passwords outside the Active Directory environment. We don't actually replicate the packages outside the firewall. So all we're doing is providing the portal and the sort of the gateway inside the firewall to access those applications. And I think it's a gradual step, but as you move things outside the firewall, people get more productive. Like that's you saw in the keynote today when he asked about
amazing, by the way.
How many people use Dropbox. Yeah. You know, almost every hand went up, right?
Or whatever, right? A lot of people.
And one reason is just that the firewall is such a barrier to getting work done, and we can't just go to Dropbox because of all the various reasons. But if we can look at some of the properties that it delivers and allow more things to be done outside of the firewall in a secure, controlled fashion, we're making steps to making people more productive.
Yep. Different topic. It's about user installed applications in the VDI space, in a pooled or stateless environment, and in other scenarios as well. So there's some demand for user installed applications. What's your opinion about user installed applications? And I'm not sure if you can talk about it, but does VMware has any plans in that space? And can, for instance, ThinApp help with that?
Yeah, well, I think you can look at user installed applications in two different ways. One is you've got a stateless desktop and let the user do anything they want and then try to remember those changes and reapply them. And I personally don't think that's ever going to work to a high enough level of quality that people
from
will
a
accept
technical perspective?
From a technical perspective. Okay. And that's because there's things that when you have different domains of administration, you've got the user administering their stuff and the administrator administering their stuff, there's going to be conflicts, and there's no automatic conflict resolution system that can be developed. What you can do, and works pretty well, and people are starting to do that, is have a catalog of applications that are available. And if they're virtualized applications, then you don't have that. They're isolated, and the administrator can do whatever they want on the desktop without worry about breaking the end user's desktop, the apps that they have provisioned. If you blow away the desktop, you can reprovision those apps through the catalog because you know
the benefits of app rooting, in essence.
Yeah. Now, the trouble with that model is somebody has to go and create that catalog of all the apps the user wants.
Or and small updates from Adobe or these kind of vendors.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And what the user wants isn't what is a business driver. Like, you know, I want Skype on my desktop, but if I go and tell the IT administrator, hey, please keep Skype as a package up to date for me, he's going to say, what's the business justification?
Yeah.
So I think ThinApp Factory is a way for us to create a large catalog of things that a user wants that don't necessarily have that business justification behind them that can enable user-installed apps on a stateless desktop model.
Okay, that's fair. Maybe you can share some future thoughts. Tomorrow, Scott Davis will have a session about end-user computing, future roadmap kind of thing. Do you have a sneak peek on that?
A sneak peek? Well, yes, tomorrow in Scott's session, which will probably be much later for this audience, but we're going to be showing off two new projects, one called App Blast, which I've worked on, another called Octopus, which is also very exciting. So the app last piece is about application remoting to a browser, yep. So that you can access.
That's what we saw tomorrow. This morning.
We saw that in the keynote when Steve pulled open Excel from Zimbra.
Yep.
It actually launched Safari in the iPad. There was nothing installed, and he was using it through the web browser, which was pretty cool. And you can do it on any HTML browser out there.
With any Windows app as well.
With any Windows app, and we'll also be supporting Linux and Mac apps.
Interesting. On the other portion about you mentioned Zimbra as well. What is special about it?
Well, I mean the cool thing about this technology is it's also as apps move to the web, they have kind of this entanglement with Windows desktop applications, and we've provided a way that they can be easily integrated. And so what you saw was, like in Zimbra, there was a little button you could say edit with App Blast, and now that document and the application came up in a couple seconds, and you start editing it right away, save it, and it goes back into Zimbra.
Do you have discussions with application compatibility in App Blast? So do you need a kind of readiness assessment for App Blast kind of apps to convert it to HTML5 or?
Nope.
Easy. That's easy. Well, that's an easy answer. Okay. Thanks. Well, I enjoyed the conversation, and I think it's useful for the audience as well. So, thanks for sharing your thoughts and for your time.